Hello, welcome to Retail Outsource. My name is Seb, and today I'm going to show you how to create a new condition of your item on Amazon. So if you are selling a new item, for example, and you have some stock of used, it can be a return from the buyer, and you have checked it and it's all working, or you refurbished, or whatever the reason might be, you can create a new condition. But for certain categories, you will not get that option, like healthcare, or personal care, or a grocery. All these categories, you will not have that option to create a used one or open box or whatever. You can only sell new. But on other certain categories like electronics or tools or gardening, you will have that option to sell used, like, or opened new. There are a few options there. So you can select that option and you can create a listing on Amazon Seller Central. The first thing I will recommend that you do is, there is a condition guidelines on Amazon. I'll put a link down in the description if you want to read through it. It's quite big, but Amazon is very specific on that. And if you see here, Amazon have given a breakdown of the categories. So you can go to that category, and for each category, it shows the conditions and it interprets the condition in different ways. So it's important that you read those conditions for your category and apply the same guidelines as Amazon want us to do on your listing. So let's jump back to the listing. And once you have logged into your Seller Central, you have to go to inventory, and under inventory, you have to click manage inventory. And the only listing that you can change the item condition, it's FBM listing. That means fulfilled by the merchant. You will not able to change anything on FBA. If you try to change anything, that means the listing will go either under suppressed or stranded inventory. So it's important that you don't touch the FBA listings. So if it's FBM, then select it and you can change it. And you have to keep in mind, you will not able to change the original listing. You are just creating a new copy of the original listing. So it's up to you if you want to keep the original one, the new one live, or you want to delete it, or you can keep both. It's up to you. So all the options are there for you to choose. So once you have selected the item, on the right hand side you can see a edit option, and there's an arrow down, so click on that, so it will expand the options. And the option that you want to select, it's add another condition, so click on that. It will open a new tab, and ideally the first thing you want to put is the SKU. So what you have to do, you can copy the original SKU from here and paste it here, and at the end you can just put hyphen used, so you can distinguish between the two listing, because at the end of the day you will have two listing here at the same. So by checking the SKU, you can easily identify it, which one is used and which one is new, and then put the price, quantity, and item condition. So again, I highly recommend that you go and check the guidelines before selecting the options here. So once you have selected the condition, just click save and finish. So that's it. So once it's done, you will have the listing here within 15 minutes. You have the two listing, and this is how it looks like on live listing. Even though with inside the inventory, it's two different SKU, the listing will come under the same ASIN. For example, this listing, you can see new and used options are there. So if you have stock on both items, it will show as available to purchase on condition new or as a used condition as well. So if I click here, you can see the buyers will get all the options. Used very good, used like new. So it's up to the buyers which one they want to buy it. So basically, you can get rid of the stock as well at the same time with Amazon used option. We do post a lot of videos about eBay and Amazon. So if that's something interests you, then please do subscribe to our channel. Thanks a lot for watching.
And remember, if you sell on eBay or Amazon and have a few questions, then you can also book a free 30-minute consultation from the link in the description below.